It's time once again for that business show with Jamie Maloney on 1250 Winds WHNZ, where business becomes show business. Jamie is a leading Tampa Bay real estate agent and featured on the Wall Street Journal's list of top 100 real estate agents in the nation. Jamie invites you to list your home with him today and learn more at tampabayradio.com. Now, live in studio and promoting the entrepreneurial spirit that drives the American economy, your host, Jamie Maloney.
Hey, good morning, everybody, and welcome to Focus Fridays on That Business Show. Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business. This weekly feature brought to us by Julianne Nichols, CEO of Focus on You Strategy, bringing out the CEO in you, and learn more about her and her many CEO exchanges over at focusonyoustrategy.com. And she also joins me today in studio, co-hosting the program with me for the hour. So Julianne, welcome to the program today.
Hi, Jamie. Great to be here.
And so we're going to be focusing on stories for entrepreneurs today. So tell us about the importance of being able to tell your story as an entrepreneur.
Well, I think everybody starts their business as an entrepreneur with a story. There's some particular reason why we become entrepreneurs. And the great thing about our guest today is that she knows how to tell you and explain how to do that. And we really want everybody to understand that when you can find and share your own personal story, it becomes a significant part of creating your own business. And it also helps you get a strong connection with running your business where you are the center of the business. It helps you get that connection with your clients.
Yeah, absolutely. It's also what people remember, and advertising campaigns need to focus on stories, because facts and figures and why you need to use me for, you know, your service, that's great. But it's the stories that people remember. As a matter of fact, I'm a realtor with Coldwell Banker. Over the last couple of years, they've really changed their marketing campaign to focus on the storytelling, the why behind why the person bought the home. And it's really made a difference in the overall sales of the company across the board. They unveiled that a couple of years ago. But yeah, definitely a focus on how to tell stories. And our guest for the hour is an excellent storyteller and a founder of the Power Stories Theater, located over on Kennedy Boulevard, and also a returning guest to the program, Miss Fran Power. So Fran, welcome to the program today.
Oh, happy to be here. Good morning.
So let's start off with just a little bit more about what Power Stories is. Tell us about your business.
Power Stories is a nonprofit theater organization, and our mission is staging true stories to open minds and hearts. And we accomplish that by producing original shows all about true stories, or we produce published works always with a true story in mind. And then we also provide leadership programs for youth and adults all about how to seek and speak your story.
And she is a returning guest. She's one of my earliest guests on the program, going back to last spring when the show just got started. And she came in today and I said, I remember you because of the story that you told me about a bike
Thank
ride.
Thank you.
And so, see, memorable stories do
Absolutely.
Last. So share that with the audience.
Well, I started Power Stories Theater on the seat of a bicycle. So I'd always wanted to ride my bike across the United States of America. So in my early 40s, I decided it's the time to do it. When else am I going to do this? So I started out in Seattle. So you can imagine being on the seat of a bicycle in Seattle, Washington at 4 o'clock in the morning, mm-hmm. and knowing your destination is Washington, D.C. So as I'm riding my bike across the country, I'm actually quite miserable because, you know, you train in Florida where it's flat,
right.
and I'm going over these mountains and I'm miserable and I keep asking myself, what the heck am I doing here?
Did you get prepped for the ride? Were you like in shape for the ride, or did you get
somewhat in shape during the ride? You know, I trained a little. Okay. I bought a new bike, you know, got the right clothes to wear, for heaven's sakes.
Right.
But as I was crossing the Wyoming border, I actually stopped, unclipped myself from the bike, and I got the answer to my question, what am I doing here? And I knew at that moment in time that the reason why I was on this bike ride was because I needed to slow down in my life, take some time, and do what I really wanted to do, which was always to start a theater. So I got back on my bike, finished the bike ride all the way to Washington, D.C., and when I got home, the hard work took place, which was to work on starting the theater. It's great to have a vision of doing something, but you have to put those thoughts in action and get moving on it.
Where were you at that inspired you to ride the bike? At what point were you at in your life? Were you working in corporate America? Were you working somewhere else? Tell me.
I had just left a position at Alpha House of Tampa. I was their executive director, had like a $2 million budget, and I was responsible for 40 pregnant women in crisis for years. And it was just, at that point in time, it wasn't exactly what I wanted to do. It was stressing me out too much, so I took a break. First time in my life I took a break. I mean, I've been working since I was 16, being from a family of 12. So I took a break, and The break was take a bike ride. My husband said that's not much of a break. But I just really wanted to do something totally for myself.
You must be a mental giant, because if I had to deal with 40 pregnant women, I would be going to look for a fast car in a cliff.
What was the time frame to get across the country from? You went from Seattle to D.C., correct?
6.5 weeks.
6.5 weeks. And did you do like 8 hours a day, 5 hours? What was the schedule?
Whatever it took you. You had about 85 miles to do every day. Okay. And the really strong testosterone guys did it in like 4 hours. It was a race to them. I took 8 to 10 hours. I was almost always the last one getting in, and it really worked on my psyche that I was in the back of the pack all the time. It was really upsetting to me. Then I realized the reason why I was at the back of the pack was because I stopped a lot to help other people, to put my feet in the water when there was a river. So I was just kind of enjoying the ride where others were like, vroom, getting through the ride.
Yeah, and so what did you, at night, did you stay in like local hotels? Did you all just camp out
somewhere?
No, we
didn't stay in hotels. It would be delightful. We had to pack a tent.
Okay, so you had a tent. So you had a tent on your back the entire ride too?
No, we had a truck taking our tent.
Okay,
but
so you didn't have
to go
the extra...
to the truck, get the tent, pitch it, and then go to sleep.
Wow, so that sounds like a fascinating experience right there. I've been, back before, got into real estate, I was an avid bike rider, and I used to ride bikes a lot as a child, and I always thought it'd be interesting to take a bike ride across the country, and so that's on my bucket list of to-dos someday.
I highly recommend it. It's life-changing.
And so did you immediately start Power Stories after the return from the, or after the arrival in D.C.? Was there a transition after that?
I began writing about it. Okay. I sat on my couch with my puppy dogs, and I was journaling all the things that I wanted to do about Power Stories, and the months were going by and I'm still just writing about it. And finally I said, girl, you can't just keep writing about it. It felt like I was doing something by writing, but you can't accomplish it by just that. So it took me several months before I actually got up, put out a press release that I was starting a theater, and I like setting goals for myself that I can't get out of. So the press knew I was starting a theater, so that's when it started.
What was the main thing that got you to get up off the couch and do that? What was the final thing that said, all right, I'm just going to go do this?
January 1st. I'm very big on dates. Uh-huh. And so it was like, okay, it's the end of the year. January 1st is rolling around. And so I wanted to start the new year with an actual action plan, with actually going to a theater and those types of things.
You kept a resolution then? Yeah, it was a New Year's resolution that people that you kept?
I kept the New Year's resolution.
I was going to say, so many people fail in keeping their New Year's resolution.
It's been 15 years, that New Year's resolution. Right, so congratulations on
Nobody
that.
Has ever told me the New Year's resolution was their catalyst for getting something done. So that's a first.
Actually,
so.
I never really thought about that, Julianne, but that's what it was. You know, January 1st was coming around. I was like, oh, boy, get going.
Now what am I going to do?
Right.
Yeah, awesome. That's great.
What was the first production then? What was that first play?
First play was called Let the Stories Move You. It was 7 women from the local community all had a personal and powerful story to tell. I helped them get out the story that they wanted to tell. It could have been a story about life, a story about starting a business, a story about losing a child. They were a mixture of comedy and dramatic stories, but all very transformative stories. And we performed that in South Tampa at the Friday Morning Music Hall, which is a building that was built by women for women. So I thought, well, that's just perfect, mm-hmm. since our mission is about women.
And you have an upcoming production on October 20th running through November 6th. So let's talk a little bit about that. Very important, Vote. So what's this going to be about? How's this going to come about?
Vote is one of our published works. We have now expanded the theater where we actually have a physical theater and we do published works. Vote is really an interesting show, and I really encourage people to get out and see it, because this year I'm hearing for the first time that a lot of people are quite apathetic about voting. And this is a play about why we cast a vote. It is true stories of characters throughout history, famous characters, Martin Luther King, George Washington, the suffrage movement, and they talk about, in a story, why they chose to cast a vote. And so if somebody is apathetic about voting, if you think about all the things that have happened in history. My husband and I recently went to Pennsylvania, and you're kind of walking the path of all the historic revolution, and then we went to Gettysburg and we watched the Civil War. All of those people were fighting for the right to vote and fighting for things to happen. And so we have to think about why it's important to vote And this play is great. It's a great family show for adults and kids on Why We Cast a Vote.
And Julianne, you have a poll currently going on the Facebook group. Let's talk about that.
Yep, it's a poll out there, and it's asking that particular question. Are you apathetic about voting? Yes, no, or you still can't decide and you need to see that play?
See that play.
Go see it at a great little black box theater on Kennedy Boulevard.
Does the play have any certain political leanings, or is it just about vote? It doesn't matter what you're going to vote for.
No, I don't want people to think this is anything like that.
Okay.
It is strictly true stories of characters. The premise is this young Natalie, an 18-year-old girl, doesn't want to vote, and all her friends are voting, and she says, it doesn't make any difference. And all of a sudden, she's transformed way back in time, and she can't get out of these time zones, and all these characters come to her and they tell their story about why they fought so hard to get the right to vote. And then, of course, in the end, we have to see the play to see what happens in the end.
Yeah, and you hear that so often, one vote doesn't matter, or voting a third party is a wasted vote. If everybody who said that would just actually vote, imagine the impact it would have on the political system. And so this is sounds like an excellent play to get out and check out about the importance of getting out to vote. And so this is going on October 20th through November 6th. That's Thursday through Saturdays, and that's 8 p.m. And also Sundays on 2 p.m. And you can pick up tickets for $25, and looks like group tickets $20 each for groups or 10 of more.
Exactly.
All right, and the theater is located on Kennedy, right? 2105 West Kennedy?
That's correct.
All right, and people can learn more about this also over at powerstories.com. Got to take a break here, but you're currently listening to the Focus Fridays edition of That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business.
Who doesn't have a smartphone these days? And of course, there's an app for everything. Well, almost everything. That's why the folks at Popcorn Apps started developing mobile applications. They saw people like you with genius ideas unable to make those thoughts a reality. They develop applications for tens of thousands of dollars less than you'll find anywhere else, and will turn your idea into a reality in a matter of just a few months. Think you're not ready? Think again. They are your one-stop shop for mobile application development. See them at popcornapps.com with a K in popcorn. Or call them at 727-415-6705 for your free consultation and pop your kernel of an idea into a million-dollar business and a world changer, starting today.
At Vane 911, we will help you feel great again. Do you have restless legs, night leg cramps, or ankle swelling? Restless legs, cramping, swelling, and tired heavy legs are often symptoms of hidden vein disease. You do not have to have visible bulging veins to have the symptoms of vein disease. The vein care specialists at Vane 911 are uniquely qualified to evaluate and treat your veins. Are you unhappy with your previous vein treatment? Vane 911 succeeds where others fail. Call Vane 911 today at 855-VANE-911. That's 855-834-6911 to book your free consultation. Vane 911. We will help you feel great again.
Are you in need of new flooring or ready to tackle that home remodeling project? Then contact Yeager & Company Incorporated, a family-owned, state-certified general contracting business with over 70 years of experience and the recipient of the Angie's List Super Service Award for the last 8 years in multiple categories. Yeager & Company comes to you with their shop-at-home flooring sales service, and their hardwood flooring refinishing is the very best in the Bay. Kitchen and bath design featuring American-made well-born cabinets, and all work is done by employees, not subcontractors. Learn more at YeagerFlooring.com.
Teresa Turner is a certified public accountant and the founder of Tax Happens, a boutique-style CPA firm providing small businesses and individuals with hands-on, personalized tax and accounting services. Although we would love to tell you how happy their clients are, we would like you to see for yourself. Tax Happens has 21 Google reviews and a 4.8-star Google rating, 17 Yelp reviews and a 5-star Yelp rating, 38 Facebook reviews and a 4.9-star Facebook rating. What sets Tax Happens apart is, number one, upfront pricing, two, clear deadlines, three, personally available year-round, and number four, a willingness to empower clients to do as much or as little as they desire. Visit TaxHappens.com for more information.
Savvy business owners utilize technology to connect with customers, communicate among teams, and collaborate with partners. Even with advances in technology, you all know it's not infallible. Where do you turn when your technology starts working against you? Who do you depend on to keep your team productive? Don't wait until your technology fails you. Get ahead of the crisis and contact the professionals at Alpha Computing Solutions so they can show you how to keep your technology running smoothly. Visit them online at www.alphacomputing.com.
If you've been following That Business Show on Facebook and Twitter, you may have noticed the quality of some of our images. That's because one of our sponsors is pro photographer Rick Caseda, a member of the Professional Photographers of America. You can view his extensive work by going to his website at rickcaseda.com or call him for an appointment to chat about your photography needs at 813-641-4757. That's 813-641-4757. Rick Caseda Visuals. Call him for your next event or project. In an age when the good and the better vie for attention, it is the best that stands out. The Best of Tampa Bay from Proudly Florida is the love story for the city of Tampa, celebrating success, sharing achievements, a tribute to enterprise and community spirit. Let Proudly Florida showcase your business to your city, your nation, and the world. For more information, email info@proudlyflorida.com and be sure to visit proudlyflorida.com.
From the RP Funding Traffic Network.
Heavy traffic on southbound 275 between Bierce and Hillsboro. Also, southbound Veterans Expressway, bit slow between Hillsboro Avenue and 275. No accidents to report right now in Hillsborough County, and in fact, Pinellas County also looking pretty good at this check. No delays to report on US 19 in either direction. See traffic problems? Call the injury firm of Abrahamson Utrecht. Hillsborough traffic tip line 866-545-9595.
This report is brought to you by the TampaYMCA.org.
I joined for the boot camps.
For the exercise classes.
I joined so I could swim 50 laps a day.
I joined
my local YMCA, and so should you.
Right now, sign up with a friend and receive 20% off both your memberships for life. Visit TampaYMCA.org.
Today, mostly sunny with a 20% chance of showers, high 91. Tonight, mostly clear, low 77. Tomorrow, a 20% rain chance, high 91.
You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney on 1250 WINS WHNZ. Missed a show? Then head over to TampaBayRadio.com, where all shows are available on demand. Once again, here's your host, Jamie Maloney.
And we're back to the Focus Fridays edition of That Business Show with Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business. Remember to continue the conversation over in the Facebook group Focus Fridays. And again, there is a poll up currently going on about if you are apathetic to voting, and so be sure to check that out and cast your vote, please. Currently in studio with Fran Powers, founder of Power Stories Theater, alongside Julianne Nichols, CEO of Focus on You Strategy, bringing out the CEO in you. So, Fran, why is your mission of staging true stories to open minds and hearts important and needed in our community?
Because we teach people how to share their story, which connects people with one another. And I think as you walk around this world and walk around your community, we need deeper understanding. We need deeper connections with each other. And so if you can know how to tell your story and even know what your story might be, whether it's a personal story, a business-related story, and if you knew how and when to share those stories, you're deepening the connection with people around you. And I can't think of a greater mission than helping to have deeper connections with people.
One of the things that we do at Focus is we really focus with our clients on how to understand their why. And a lot of it comes from your own personal story, why you do what you do. And people buy the why and the results of what you do. They don't buy the how. So it's really important to understand that story of why and why you and what your story is to connect with that client so that they'll want to do business with you.
Now, are the productions that go on throughout the year, are these all personal stories of, you know, an entrepreneur or somebody who accomplished something? Tell me about the mix that goes on throughout the year at Power Stories.
There's really two major things that are going on. One is exactly that. And our history and our foundation has always been about producing original shows with true stories, helping individuals in corporate America or just the general public how to tell their story, the true story. So that's one major piece of what we do, and it will always be the foundation. I have such a deep belief in that. Since we actually now have a theater, physical space, we are now publishing also works. Some of those are true stories. Like last year we did Decision Height, which was a story about Air Force service pilots. Then we also do some other shows that are not true, but they're real life acted out. We're doing a show this year called Falling, which is about an autistic son. It is not a true story, but it's very definitely something that millions of families are dealing with right now. So it's very socially rich stories. And the result of producing something like that is to allow people then to share their story with one another, i.e., deepening the connection, and i.e. fulfilling our mission.
Now, how do cast members get involved? Are they paid actors? Is this on a volunteer basis? Can people, do different people come in and out of the plays? How does all that come together?
We put the, you know, general word out that we're looking for actors. We have a really great relationship with the University of Tampa. Yep. We have a kind of a work program with them. Actors are sometimes paid. We tell them up front that it's a volunteer, but we have always paid our actors. It's not a living wage. It's just a little bit of something at the end of our show. So all of our actors end up getting paid at the end of the show.
That's much better than Hollywood and, you know, the director trying to get favors from, you know what I mean?
Exactly. Exactly.
Yeah, there's no couch casting.
We do a great job with getting fabulous talent. I mean, we had some really good talent on our shows.
Yes.
So how else does the Power Stories get its message out across the community? Obviously, the plays are being instrumental in getting your message across in the community, the importance of stories. How else is Power Stories reaching out?
It's kind of guerrilla marketing. It's... We do a lot of social media, you know, we do a lot of speaking engagements. We're always doing press releases. We have the physical presence of being on Kennedy Boulevard. That's always a challenge for us, getting our message out. And Julianne is on our board of directors, so she understands how difficult that can be. But we manage to do that. You know, we educate people about what we're doing in a lot of different ways.
Now, what about classes and just, you know, not actual productions or anything? What else goes on at Power Stories or does that?
We have our Girl Stories Leadership Theater Program. And when Julianne talks about the why, one of the main reasons why we are doing all the things that we're doing is so that we can bring money in so that we can help more young girls. So we really believe that everybody has a personal and powerful story to share. We understand that. And there's all kinds of target audience that you could spend time with. You could spend time with veterans or entrepreneurs. So we have selected this target audience of working with middle school girls. That's a time in their life when they could go wacky bad or really great good. And so we want to get them. We have like 60 middle school girls that we serve, Sulphur Springs, Tampa, Wyomama. And we help them feel courageous and strong about who they are. We are currently doing a show called Advice I Would Give My Younger Self. And at the end of the show, we had two moms come up to talk to the audience, because why we're doing that show is to bring in more money for young girls. And to hear the moms talk about how their girls have been transformed by becoming involved with Girl Stories Leadership Theater is a beautiful thing to hear.
If I remember right, when you were in last year, there was a production coming up that was focused on something along those lines. I don't know if you recall the production that was last spring, but it was something to do with a young girl coming of age and some of the challenges that she was facing. I don't know if you can recall
we
that.
We were probably doing a Stop Kiss at that time.
That's what it was,
and
yes.
It was a story of two young women. They were unsure of their sexuality.
That's right. That's right. I remember it was something along themselves as a younger woman.
That was one of our published works. And then we always do a show in the summertime featuring the girls. And this last year we did a show on women in history with the young girls, and it was just absolutely fabulous.
And your upcoming production, Vote, is currently being produced, and it'll be on from October 20th through November 6th. So people can pick up tickets over at powerstories.com, and these productions are going to be going on Saturdays at 8 p.m. and Sundays at 2 p.m. from October 20th through November 6th. Tickets available for $25 in group sales for $20 if you have groups 10 or more. We've got a lot more with Fran Powers and Julianne Nichols when we come back from the break. In the meantime, remember to continue the conversation in the Facebook group Focus Fridays. A poll is currently up right now about your propensity to vote. So be sure to participate in that and cast your vote in the poll, please. You're listening to the Focus Fridays edition of That Business Show. Jamie Maloney, your business becomes show business.
I feel guilty that I can't always be there when Mom feels stuck at home. She was always there for us. But now she can't get out, and I'm not always available to take her places. Someone else needs to help her get around. Then I learned about Home Instead. Now Mom can do what she enjoys because her personal caregiver is there, and I can just be a daughter again.
Are you struggling to care for your loved one? We can help. Home Instead Senior Care. To us, it's personal.
Hi, welcome to Yeager's. We just want to take a minute and show you what we're all about. At Yeager's, our primary business is hardwood flooring, although we are remodelers for kitchen, bath, and general construction. We operate a fleet of shop-at-home vans that have all the flooring-type products, hardwood flooring, laminate flooring, tiles, stone, what have you. So we're able to come out first with products in our vehicles and take a look at the setting, how the colors will work, and then to be able to come up with some options and ideas for you. If that's not good enough, we have a large distribution center that we inventory product and have a nice display area.
Expressway from around 301 to 50th Street. See traffic problems? Call the injury firm of Abrahamson Newdirk. Hillsborough Traffic Tip Line, 866-545-9595.
This report is brought to you by Bexley. Looking for adventure in a place you can call your own? Bexley, a new home community coming to Pasco County this October, will offer miles of trails, acres of open space, and new homes, now pre-selling. Learn more at BexleyFlorida.com. That's BexleyFlorida.com.
1250 winds, weather center forecast, low 90s for the high today, another warmer and drier day, lots of sunshine, small chance for a pop-up storm. Tonight's low in the mid to upper 70s. Through the weekend, expect to see a bit more rain back in the forecast, 30-40% chance each day, upper 80s, low 90s. Impact Radio, 1250 winds, WHNZ.
You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney on 1250 Winds WHNZ. Missed a show? Then head over to TampaBayRadio.com, where all shows are available on demand. Once again, here's your host, Jamie Maloney.
And welcome back to the Focus Fridays edition of That Business Show. Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business. This weekly segment brought to us by Julianne Nichols, CEO of Focus on You Strategy, bringing out the CEO in you. And Julianne, you do a number of CEO exchanges throughout the month. The next one coming up on October 4th, and people can register at focusonyoustrategy.com. Just go to the events calendar up in the upper right-hand corner of the page. But Julianne, tell us a little bit more about what people can get out of a CEO exchange.
CEO exchanges are basically like mini masterminds where you can come and present a challenge, and some of your business peers who understand and get it will help you through it. Yesterday, we had our first with our newest partner, Regis, which is a virtual office space. And we were sold out, and it was amazing. The different businesses that show up, and they have some issues, and they worked them all out, and people left there. They wanted to keep going, but you know, right. I was like, the 2 hours is up, people, sorry.
Right.
But it was great. It was really great. And so you can come and do that. Our next one is at C1 Bank, now known as Bank of the Ozarks, I must say. And it is at the Hyde Park location over on South Boulevard.
Yep, C1 Banks have been bought by the Bank of the Ozarks, so you'll be seeing that transition going on over the next few months. I think they've already changed out a lot of the.
They're Pinellas starting County. To, yeah.
Yeah, they're starting to change them out, mm-hmm. Yeah. So C1 Banks are now being owned by Bank of Ozarks, so be looking out for that change. In studio here, also alongside Fran Powers, founder and executive director of Power Stories Theater, located over on Kennedy Boulevard. Learn more at powerstories.com, and we're talking about the importance of storytelling for entrepreneurs to get their message out and really help to build a brand and get, you know, their product sold to the community. You know, Fran, how can entrepreneurs get involved with Power Stories?
Well, every nonprofit is built on the backs of great volunteers, you know. So there's really, you know, entrepreneurs could choose to volunteer. They could choose to come to a show. They could choose to get more educated about how they can use the power of story in their business. You know, one of the easy ways is to just come to our theater, see a show, bring friends. That's kind of a double benefit for them because they're learning about the power of story in a presentation. So they're being entertained, they're watching a presentation, but they also know their ticket is helping to serve more young girls who are also trying to find their voice also. there's lots of different ways that entrepreneurs can get involved.
One of the great things that Fran has is a business version of the Seek and Speak workshop.
Correct.
And this is where a business person or entrepreneur, you know, they're always interested in the bottom line, right, of success. So that bottom line may be their ability to lead, direct a company or a team, or it may be their ability to sell and increase the bottom line. And anyway, Power Stories helps professionals be successful with this Seek and Speak series, and it's tailored to the business audience. I think it's a really unique and fresh approach to personal and professional development using some tried and true techniques from the theater that can transform your approach to business. And Fran is excellent at teaching that.
And also you have opportunities for sponsorships. How does sponsorships work? Do people sponsor the play, or how does that work?
We have a lot of sponsorship opportunities. Our current published works, our season of shows, all have different themes. Obviously, we've talked about Vote. We're doing a show in December about family values. We're doing another show about the youth's obsession with being famous, and then the one about autism. So a company could sponsor one of those shows, and for that sponsorship, we just put their logo on all of our website, on the front window where Kennedy Boulevard is filled with traffic, etc. And then we also have our social enterprise venture that is going on right now. Well, we won the business competition last year, $25,000 to kick this off. We beat out many other organizations. And this is a series of plays that we have developed, and we have one in our inventory right now. It's a series about money. What advice would you give your younger self about money? And we talked to lots of other people around the world, and we focused in on a 55-minute fun show with music about that topic. This show is for sale, and entrepreneurs may want to say, you know what, I wouldn't mind buying that show so that I can invite 60 prospective guests to come in. I can pitch to them before the show. I could do a workshop with them after the show. And what we promise that entrepreneur is that by the time the show is done, their audience is going to be happy, they're going to be warm, they're going to be relaxed, going to be receptive, and have a deeper understanding about the Power Story.
And they're going to learn something, right?
Because absolutely.
If I had to go back in time as 36-year-old me, I would go back and see 20-year-old me and say, dude, nothing's changed.
Yeah, exactly. And these 15 true stories are from women around the country, and their messages are just fabulous. Several of them, Julianne, are about entrepreneurs.
They are. It's a great show. It
about
really
people
is.
Who have started their business and have been successful. And there's even one of my favorites from Julie Ravello. I had to beg her to tell this story because it's so good. She started a business, and in her mind, it failed. And I said, Julie, you got to tell that story. People are always afraid of taking a risk because they're afraid of it failing. But she loved the process of doing it. She hated it at the end, but the outcome was she got back into what she really loves to do, which is pediatric nursing. Mm-hmm. And so she had to get that off her bucket list to start that business.
Right.
Otherwise, she would never be happy today doing what she's doing.
Or
so
she'll always wonder.
Always
and so,
wonder.
Oh, should
exactly.
I have done that?
You don't
want to
be on your deathbed thinking, I should have started that business. You know, you got to do it.
Right.
So a lot of the stories in that show are about that.
They yeah. are.
Yeah. Now, you say the story is, or the play is for sale. Does that mean you produce it just for that one audience, or can multiple audiences or multiple groups come out and see the production? How does that work specifically?
The show is for sale. People can come to Power Stories Theater to buy a night there and okay. use the theater there. Or if they want to, we will travel to St. Louis or San Francisco or whatever. It's built for portability in mind. It's built with customization in mind.
Okay.
And it's only three actors, and they're professional actors telling the true story. So it's a compact show that we can, you know, get on a plane and go perform.
So this would be a good production for somebody that, you know, has a sales, you know, heavy in sales business and kind of put their clients out there in the audience. And so what type of a group would they need in terms of numbers to make it effective for them? What would you recommend that they have in the audience?
You mean the amount of people
coming
in?
Yeah, the amount of people coming in.
We have a 60-seat theater at Power Stories Theater, but they could have hundreds come in to see the show. We've performed similar shows like this in huge audiences of 400 and 500. It really does perform best when you have more of a smaller audience, 100 or so people, because the show itself is meant to be more intimate, but it can work in much larger audiences.
And is the show then specific to just that audience? Do you bring in other people for the program that day, or is it just for that audience?
The show is just for that audience. So the show doesn't change basically doesn't change. But because there's 15 stories, I tell somebody, Jamie, if you have a story about money that you really want told, I'll take out Julie's story, even though I love it, and I'll put your story in. Very easy to do, so that you can say it's a 55-minute show generally about the advice I would give myself about money, but my story's in there.
It's a great opportunity to host your clients and colleagues at these events. I mean, it's an intimate theater, and learning from life stories create a connection on a deeper level. We talked a lot about this during here, but it opens the conversation about the story of the business.
Yeah. Exactly. I always ask the audience, what's your favorite? And some of the stories are quieter. They're not as fun and full with, you know, pumping your fist in the air. Last night or Wednesday night, we had a VIP reception by State Farm. The night before, we had one by Bank of Tampa. And I asked this gentleman, we have a lot of gentlemen in our shows, you know, come to our shows, what was your favorite story? And he said, it was a story where the mom couldn't decide whether she should pay the mortgage or buy her child a new pair of shoes. Mm-hmm. And the storyteller kept saying, mortgage or shoes, mortgage or shoes. And Mark said, that was the piece. That was the one sentence that struck home in my heart, because my mom raised three boys, you know, single mom, and she was always struggling with that. So if we can pierce someone's heart with one sentence in one of our shows, job well done.
Where did the ideas for the different productions come about? And do you ever bring in, like, you know, plays that are, you know, produced like on Broadway or, you know, nationally produced, or are they always just local creations that you've put together?
Well, our published works, a lot of our published works have been off Broadway. The one that we're doing in April, Falling, was done off Broadway. So they have been, a lot of them have been off Broadway. They're not just local shows. The original series, those tend to be our shows that we kind of put together. And we have a lot of help from the community putting those shows together, because I have to seek people's true stories. We have to figure out what the theme should be. Mm-hmm. This first thing with the original show was money. Why do we pick that theme?
Right.
We asked hundreds of women, what is something that you're still not talking about as a woman? And we found out that women don't talk about money so much. Mm-hmm. They might talk about how much a pair of shoes was, but they don't talk about their financial security and their fears about that.
Yeah,
that's why we built the show about that.
Yeah, I can definitely attest to that. I definitely noticed the men bring up the financials a lot more than the women do.
Especially when the shoes are worth about as much as your mortgage.
Exactly. We have a really cute scene in the play about a mom saying to her daughter, you cannot buy that pair of expensive shoes, you know.
So, Julianne, you sit on the board of Power Stories. How did you and Fran meet? How did this all come together?
Actually, I met Fran shortly after I moved here 3 years ago. I went to an event and met her business development director, who invited me to what they had was a women's power lunch. Mm-hmm. And that was the first time I had met Fran, and hearing her story and hearing about what they do with women and young girls, I was totally intrigued. I, too, come from a theater background. I went to college on a Fulbright theater scholarship, so I've been in theater many years, so it drew me in, one thing, and then also just the whole mission behind empowering young girls at an age where they need it so much. And I was all in, and immediately became her gala chair for the next 3 years.
She was all in, so what do? You get him right there with the gala.
So she did.
Songbirds and stuff.
So you went to college on a Fulbright Theater Scholarship. I didn't even know that was even possible. How does that happen? You were an actress in high school, and people saw you.
I was actually on the technical side more. I really wanted to direct movies with Steven Spielberg, but he never called me back, so ended up becoming a private detective. You know, life takes you.
But
in
how
different
directions. How do you get discovered? I mean, you know, playing football, basketball, you know, that's all real popular and well known.
Well, in technical theater, I had done a lot of work in my high school that drew attention. I'm one of those overachievers, you know, so I'm all in. Mm-hmm. But I did a lot of community theater. I had done a lot of theater since I was a very young age, and I acted, but it wasn't my where I really wanted to be. Mm-hmm. I loved designing the lights, designing sets. And so I had a great theater teacher who actually gave me those opportunities, and they were all in letting me do it. I was actually one of the first people to direct a full-length play at my high school. Interesting. And so that became, so I submitted all of that to the colleges and.
Interesting. I didn't know.
So
you
we're going to get
ride?
Julianne to direct a play one of these days.
Yeah. I had never met somebody who's got a full ride to college on a theater. That's interesting. I didn't know that was possible. I thought just athletes and, you know, people in sports got that type of stuff. So interesting. So currently talking to Fran Powers, founder of the Power Stories Theater located over on Kennedy Boulevard. Learn more, powerstories.com, and also alongside Julianne Nichols, CEO of Focus On You Strategy, bringing out the CEO in you. And again, continue the conversation in the Facebook group Focus Fridays, where there's currently a poll up on about your propensity to vote, which is in conjunction with the upcoming play entitled Vote that Fran is putting on, and that's going to begin starting on October 20th and running through November 6th. And you can pick up tickets over at powerstories.com. You're listening to That Business Show. Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business.
Have you ever tried to buy a home for your family only to find out that you don't qualify for a mortgage loan? You thought that after 20 years as a customer of your bank, they would help you when you needed it the most, right? Unfortunately, the banks of today are not the banks of our parents and grandparents, and our relationships with them just don't matter anymore. My name is Frank Cotto, and I'm the president of the Lincoln Lending Group. We all may need a bank, but we also need a Frank, and that's what I'm here to do for you today. Lincoln Lending Group will waive all of your lending fees, which include your mortgage, application fee, your underwriting fee, processing fees, and any bank points. Just call 813-MORTGAGE. You drop the E, and we'll drop the fee.
Who doesn't have a smartphone these days? And of course, there's an app for everything. Well, almost everything. That's why the folks at Popcorn Apps started developing mobile applications. They saw people like you with genius ideas unable to make those thoughts a reality. They develop applications for tens of thousands of dollars less than you'll find anywhere else and will turn your idea into a reality in a matter of just a few months. Think you're not ready? Think again. They are your one-stop shop for mobile application development. See them at popcornapps.com with a K in popcorn. Or call them at 727-415-6705 for your free consultation and pop your kernel of an idea into a million-dollar business and a world changer starting today.
Teresa Turner is a certified public accountant and the founder of Tax Happens, a boutique-style CPA firm providing small businesses and individuals with hands-on, personalized tax and accounting services. Although we would love to tell you how happy their clients are, we would like you to see for yourself. Tax Happens has 21 Google reviews and a 4.8-star Google rating, 17 Yelp reviews and a 5-star Yelp rating, 38 Facebook reviews and a 4.9-star Facebook rating. What sets Tax Happens apart is number one, upfront pricing, two, clear deadlines, three, personally available year-round, and number four, a willingness to empower clients to do as much or as little as they desire. Visit taxhappens.com for more information.
Savvy business owners utilize technology to connect with customers, communicate among teams, and collaborate with partners. Even with advances in technology, you all know it's not infallible. Where do you turn when your technology starts working against you? Who do you depend on to keep your team productive? Don't wait until your technology fails you. Get ahead of the crisis and contact the professionals at Alpha Computing Solutions so they can show you how to keep your technology running smoothly. Visit them online at www.alphacomputing.com.
Are you in need of new flooring or ready to tackle that home remodeling project? Then contact Yeager & Company Incorporated, a family-owned, state-certified general contracting business with over 70 years of experience and the recipient of the Angie's List Super Service Award for the last 8 years in multiple categories. Yeager & Company comes to you with their shop-at-home flooring sales service, and their hardwood flooring refinishing is the very best in the Bay. Kitchen and bath design featuring American-made, well-born cabinets, and all work is done by employees, not subcontractors. Learn more at JaegerFlooring.com. Did you know the biggest challenge business leaders face today is creating an engaged and productive workforce culture? Bill Meyer Ham Consulting wants to help you solve this challenge. They will help you transform your workforce culture to produce amazing business results. Call Bill Meyer Ham Consulting at 941-201-4650 today or visit BillMeyerHam.com. That's BillMeyerHam.com. Have a conversation. What's up, business rock stars? Are you ready to bring out the CEO in you? Join Julianne Nichols, CEO of Focus On You Strategy, every other Friday on That Business Show. She'll be talking with other chief entrepreneurial officers about how they grew their businesses. Remember, you could join the conversation at Focus On You Strategy's Focus Fridays Facebook group at facebook.com/groups/Focus Fridays. That's facebook.com/groups/Focus Fridays. Be the CEO of you.
From the RP Funding Traffic Network.
Crash and St. Pete on 66th Street, just south of 38th Avenue North. Also, all lanes blocked on southbound Little Road at Trouble Creek. This, of course, in Pasco County. Avoid this area. Southbound 275, slow between Fletcher Avenue and Sly. And some slow traffic on southbound Veterans Expressway between Waters Avenue and Hillsboro. See traffic problems? Call the injury firm of Abrahamson Utrecht. Hillsboro traffic tip line, 866-545-9595.
This report is brought to you by McDonald's. Sip into a great morning with McDonald's McCafe Coffee. McDonald's McCafe Coffee is made with sustainably sourced 100% Arabica beans and brewed hot and fresh just for you. Enjoy any size hot McCafe coffee for $1, only at McDonald's for a limited time.
Today, mostly sunny with a 20% chance of showers, high 91. Tonight, mostly clear, low 77. Tomorrow, a 20% rain chance, high 91.
You're listening to That Business Show with Jamie Maloney on 1250 WINS WHNZ. Missed a show? Then head over to TampaBayRadio.com, where all shows are available on demand. Once again, here's your host, Jamie Maloney.
And welcome back to Focus Fridays on That Business Show. Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business. Talking to Julianne Nichols, CEO of Focus on You Strategy, alongside Fran Powers, founder of Power Stories Theater. So, Fran, it's important that entrepreneurs have a story to help sell themselves and their brand, but also that you talk about at Power Stories, the young women, you know, 14, 15, it's important that they develop a story to help them guide them through life and be successful. Elaborate on this some more.
It's a foundation of our Girl Stories Leadership Theater program. It's the very first thing that we work with the girls on is what is your story and the power of knowing their story and sharing it. They share their story with elementary school kids so that they can feel the whole cycle of sharing and receiving that story. It's also very important that they know their story because they can use that throughout their life. Many of the young girls come to our program because they want to become young leaders, but they also really are big into theater. So they have dreams, and we always want them to dream big. They have dreams of going to Broadway. We have some that are just want to do technical theater, or they want to do costuming. So we kind of, you know, work with them on helping them believe that their dreams can come true. But at the base of it is know your story.
Now, Julianne, you shared a story with me during the break that was pretty interesting. You had the full ride scholarship going to college, but then you found another opportunity that unfortunately you didn't take. But one of your friends resulted in a movie. Tell a story for this.
Yeah, yeah. I went to college because I wanted to be a film director. I wanted to direct movies with Steven Spielberg, but he never called me back. So, but what ended up happening is there was a group of us that went and had applied for the Academy of Dramatic Arts in Pasadena, and I was unable to go, but a guy I was actually dating at the time, he did go. And probably about 6 months later, we get a call from him saying, hey, I got my first movie. And I'm like, what? And he's like, yeah, it's a Stanley Kubrick movie. I'm like, I'm going to London. And ended up being Full Metal Jacket.
Oh, wow.
And he had a major role in, or not a major role, but a big part in that movie.
He was, you said he was one of the soldiers in that scene where they're being shot at by the sniper and stuff,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, he was the guy getting shot at that they were trying to get to. His name was Doc J in the movie. And I see him occasionally on bit parts. We were watching Homeland one night on Showtime, and I was like, that guy looks really familiar. And then it dawned on me, oh, that's a older version of John. Yeah, I see him now, you know.
That's so awesome. Kind of fun. I'm a big fan of that movie. I've seen it probably a couple of dozen of times. And I say a lot of times on this program, a lot of one-liners have come from that movie. A lot of them dirty, but so I can't repeat them. But a lot of one-liners come out of that movie that you probably don't even realize came out of Full Metal Jacket.
Really?
So
that's right.
It had quite the impact on our culture.
But there's a lot of things that happen. I know for me as a strategist working with other businesses, you know, people think, oh, you probably don't understand this, you don't understand that. But when I start to tell them my story about where I came from, I've had so many things I've done in my lifetime. I've been a disc jockey. I've been a private detective for 15 years. I was a handbag designer. I was in the mortgage business. I do get.
And you focus, and you also have a hobby in genealogy, too.
Yes, I do. I do. So there's a wide variety of things that that have my story that helps me relate to my clients. And I, especially as a woman, I relate on a lot of levels, fears, single parents, you know, things like that. So it just always amazes me how important it is to understand your story, be able to tell it so that you can connect. And that is, I think, the biggest thing we're trying to make today is how business owners can connect to their clients by understanding the power of their own story.
And it's not just understanding the power of the story. You have to be able to be comfortable to share it.
Yes.
I work with a lot of people who say, okay, yeah, I know what my story is, but I don't want to tell that story. You know, if you tell the story in keeping in mind that you're giving a gift to your audience, that they need to hear that story. It's a selling tool. It helps connect your audience with yourself. Then they feel more comfortable sharing the story. We're not asking people to share your deepest, darkest secrets, but those value stories, those things you learn from your mom, those things you learn from your dad, those things that you learn from past businesses. When you talk about that, I mean, just look at the people in the room. If I knew something more personal about you through the a story.
I keep crackers in my nightstand. Sorry.
Okay, now I know more about you. Yeah. It helps paint that picture. I mean, there's an Indian proverb that says, tell me a story and it'll live in my heart forever. And that's important. We want to remember the people that we're dealing with. So there's a saying in theater called breaking the fourth wall. And that's what we're trying to do with storytelling. We want entrepreneurs and business people to break that fourth wall, and connect more with your audience. Don't play the role so much on stage. Break the fourth wall, tell your story so that you can have a deeper understanding of someone that you're talking with.
Absolutely. I really feel like I really wanted Fran on today just because of this. It just seems to come out more and more. We're hearing more and more of different people talking about the importance of storytelling. You've been doing this for well over 15 years now, just with Power Stories alone. And it's coming to the forefront more and more. And I wanted somebody who's been doing this all along to just been more like the pioneer in this area for
right.
telling stories and is nationally acclaimed for her work. And I just wanted business owners to understand this is an important part of running your business.
Absolutely. And I've talked with many of business owners on here. I know have great stories, but they just can't tell them sometimes too.
Well, I think also you need to understand too that not every story has to be a victim story.
Oh, like, absolutely.
You can have some great stories in your life that are successes or even big failures or, you know.
So I had the CEO of a company come to me about a year ago, and he was not a very good speaker. He's a brilliant man. I mean, off the chart brilliant. But he couldn't communicate what he was trying to move to an audience because he was so brilliant. And so I worked with him individually for months, and I helped him tell this silly little fun story about how his mother helped him ride a bicycle. His brothers rode a bicycle, but he was afraid to ride the bicycle, and his mom would hold on to the bike and finally let go of the bike, and he would soar. And he now tells that story in front of thousands of people. And his wife came to me and said, you know, you've really helped my husband. So
wow,
it was a simple little story. Universal.
Incredible. An incredible hour here on Focus Fridays on That Business Show. So Fran Powers, Julia Nichols, both of you, thank you so much.
Thank you.
And learn more about Focus on You Strategy over at focusonyoustrategy.com and register for one of the upcoming CEO exchanges and learn more about yourself and your business through a small intimate group setting where Julianne can help you out with that. Again, focusonyoustrategy.com and also more about Power Stories over at powerstories.com and be sure to catch their upcoming production Vote going on October 20th through November 6th. Tickets available online at powerstories.com and you can pick them up for just $25. You've been listening to the Focus Fridays edition of That Business Show. Jamie Maloney, where business becomes show business. The proceeding was a